Hi, Internet. Welcome to the Greg Troyan YouTube channel. It is Thin Lizzy Thursday, and this almost didn't happen this week. My computer completely crashed, had to wipe the hard drive, do a reboot to factory settings, lost all my files. Luckily, I had backed up most of my important files. I did lose a draft of a screenplay I was working on, which is very annoying, because I thought I had backed it up. I still have all my notes, but basically have to start that from scratch. But, you know, I'm back, up and running, and excited to do Thin Lizzy Thursday with you guys, and you know, big shout-out to Windows for your updates crashing my computer all the time. Yeah, but you know what, looking at the positivity, this week we're finally doing it. We're doing the big one. We're doing The Boys Are Back in Town. I feel a bit bad for that rambly kind of bad intro to one of the greatest rock songs in history, one of the greatest songs in history. But, you know, that's what you get with unscripted reactions. We don't know, you know, how this is going to go. Thin Lizzy Thursday, for those who don't know, for first-time viewers, because, hey, this is the big Thin Lizzy song. It's probably going to get more views every week. I, a big Thin Lizzy fan, just break down a song in the catalog, break down the components, talk about what I like, what I don't like, in a very unscripted, loose, conversational manner. And so, I've been kind of dancing around this one for a while because it's their big hit. You know, this is their Come On Eileen. You know, in the United States, Thin Lizzy is basically a one-hit wonder. This is their one hit. And so, what do I have to say about this song that hasn't been said? Well, we're gonna find out, so let's listen to The Boys Are Back in Town. And, yes, we do the pauses on the channel because, you know, that's how we break things down. And, excuse me, I'm feeling a cough coming. Anyway, so, to start off, you've got these big, held-out, you know, epic power chords, which, you know, is probably inspiration from The Who, because they were sort of one of the first bands to really make that, like, a core tenet of their sound and style, was there's this Pete Townshend, you know, his whirlwind arm, and just holding out those massive, massive power chords, and that became just a staple of the classic rock sound, just those big, held-out power chords. You know, Kiss did it with Detroit Rock City, you know, Bachman-Turner Overdrive would do it. That's just, like, a thing that a lot of bands would do, and I think it's done brilliantly here. I think the guitar tone is excellent, just like has the perfect amount of bite and like volume to it. Like it rings out nicely. Like there's, you know, the tone sustains for a good amount of time. It's punctuated by, you know, a little nice riffing in between the power chords and a very great drum beat with a lot of swing to it. And the chord progression for the song, you know, especially during the verses, is a little bit counterintuitive for most musicians. A lot of people wouldn't necessarily write songs this way, but it's a very, you know, clever, great chord progression, and allows for an excellent melody on top, which we're about to get into. But really, it's brilliantly, brilliantly composed. I'm getting ahead of myself because I know this one so well. But just a great intro. Let's get into the verse. Guess who just got back today? Them wild-eyed boys that had been away. Haven't changed, had much to say. But man, I still think them cats are great. They were asking if you were around, how you was, where you could be found. I told them you were living downtown, driving all the old men crazy. We'll be right back. All right, so much brilliance to go over. Where do I even begin? So let's start with, great vocal and lyric by Phil Lynott. Originally, the song, the original concept of it was to be about, like, soldiers returning home from war. It was supposed to be called G.I. Joe originally. And then it got morphed into The Boys Are Back in Town, which I think was more of a more universal message, because it didn't necessarily just have to be about soldiers coming home from war, which, ironically, he addressed in other songs like Soldier of Fortune. But also, it's like, someone who maybe left town for work, moved out of town to follow their dreams, left town for college, left town for war, coming back. But it's about, a homecoming for individuals who had left, a band on tour, coming back home and being celebrated by the people of the town because, they're boys from the town, they're loved by the community, they're missed by the community. They've been out there, taking on the world, making the world their own, but there's still that bond and appreciation for home, and it's just, it's an anthem that so many people can relate to. And, for those who have listened to my podcast, The Lipstick Panel, we got into a little bit of a tussle, my bassist and I, because he doesn't like that lyrical message because he grew up in a small town in Wisconsin, and he said that when the boys came back home, they were a bunch of assholes who just got drunk and they were obnoxious, and he didn't like the boys coming back home, and so he associated the song with negative memories. And, I get that to a degree, but for me, I think this song is such a fun party anthem, with, great lyrics, great swagger. It just, for me, this checks all the boxes, and brilliant production, excellent harmony vocals, the panning of the vocals are great, the, slight fluctuations of the melody, and of course, those trademark harmony Thin Lizzy guitars. Like, I know a lot of people, when they are really into a band, they won't let the big hits. They'll be like, oh man, I don't want to listen to that trash, and they're only into the deep cuts. For me, every time the song comes on the radio, like, I turn it up because I love it. I don't care if I've heard it a million times. A great song is a great song. Oh man, do I do it? Yeah, I'll call out Andy and Alex. I know this is an S-rank song. You guys only giving it an A. Yeah, that's madness. This is S-rank. This is perfection. This is like a top-tier classic rock song. Even people who aren't, into Thin Lizzy as much as I am, like, will probably acknowledge this is, like, one of the biggest hits of classic rock radio, one of the biggest hits of the 70s. This is just, like, a absolute stone-cold classic. Everybody knows this song. Like, this is pop culture. Like, you've heard it in movies, you've heard it in TV shows. Even people who don't consider themselves Thin Lizzy fans, like, know this song, as evidenced, when we did the Lipstick Panel episode on Jailbreak. We had, a millennial on who, didn't know any Thin Lizzy songs, but knew The Boys Are Back in Town, because it's sort of inescapable. And, like, surprising if you don't know it. I mean, it's possible to have not heard it, but, like, that chorus, I feel like almost everyone in the world has heard that chorus, and I'm really, like, surprised if you had, like, gone an entire life, and, like, even someone who doesn't listen to rock, like, that song is hard to escape. But yeah, you know what, let's get back to it. Rewind just a hair. You know that chick that used to dance a lot? Every night she'd be on the floor shaking what she'd got. Man, when I tell you she was cool, she was red hot. I mean, she was steaming. And that time over at Johnny's place, well, this chick got up and she slapped Johnny's face. Man, we just fell about the place. If that chick don't wanna know, forget her. Yeah, the conversational tone of the lyrics are just coming off really well, but also there's great melody to it. So Phil is just coming off as a super smooth, charismatic front man, and yeah, just freaking killer. The boys are back in town, the boys are back in town. I said, the boys are back in town, the boys are back in town. The boys are back in town, the boys are back in town, the boys are back in town, the boys are back in town. We'll be right back. freaking great vocal. Friday night they'll be dressed to kill down at Dino's Bar and Grill. The drink will flow and blood will spill. And if the boys want to fight, you better let them. That jukebox in the corner blasting out my favorite song. The nights are getting warmer, it won't be long. Won't be long till summer comes. Now that the boys are here again. So there's a certain irony to the line, you know, that jukebox in the corner blasting out my favorite song, in that this song has been blasted out of the corner of so many jukeboxes, and has become like this big sing-along anthem. Like, you know, play this in a bar, you'll get a bunch of people singing along to it. It's infectious. And, you know, this is a great example of Phil's songwriting, and it's really just like the tip of the iceberg to, you know, a great catalog of songs. Just, yeah, excellent, excellent stuff. And, of course, ending on the fade in the studio version, but the live version ending is absolutely killer. And we do have a Dino's in Nashville, a great little burger joint. I don't know if they're still in business because of the pandemic. Wishing them well. You know, wishing to get back to a point where it's, you know, safe to go out into a bar and sing this with everyone in the room and have a jolly good time. When I went back to Cleveland and played my first shows after having moved there, it was like 5 or 6 years after leaving the city. I don't remember. I don't know how long I've been gone from Cleveland. The years blur together, but you know, it's been a long time. And when we did some dates in Cleveland and we opened those shows with the Boys Are Back in Town, even though I was the only boy who was back in town and the rest of them were Nashville guys, you know, we still opened with it. And, you know, a song that people knew that, you know, got the crowd singing along, goodwill towards the band right away. You know, it's hard to know what to say about, you know, this song because so many things have been said about already. You've got a great bass line. You've got, killer drumming. You've got very tasteful guitar playing, excellent dynamics, great vocals. Great lyrics because they paint a picture so well. So it doesn't necessarily need to be... I'm trying to think of how to say this. Something can be deep and profound without trying to be deep and profound. So there is something about just the sheer joy of the... of, like, being young, exploring the world, and when you return home after one of those journeys, and the celebratory nature that that brings. And that is something that is very true to life. And even if, let's say, you know, I'm not necessarily the biggest fan of my hometown for a number of reasons, and I left for a reason, even if I don't have that... exact communal spirit when returning, I'm able to still appreciate a lot of the sentiments of the song. There's still this infectious joy that is inescapable from this piece. And, you know, not meaning to rag on Cleveland too much. There's positives about the city. There's negatives about the city. And for me, it was better for me to ultimately leave, and I did. And, you know, people from the town ask, when are you coming back? When are you moving back? And I'm like, I've been gone for a decade, and my stuff is here, so I'm not going anywhere because all my stuff is here. Oh, yeah, it's going to be coming up on 10 years in 2022. So, yeah, 10 years. But... like, for this is an undeniable classic of just pop music, period. Whether you're a fan of classic rock or hard rock or whatever, like, this song is a stone cold classic, has, you know, and like is still thriving to this day. Like, it's a song that hasn't lost momentum. It's a classic. I feel like only the most cynical would not be able to appreciate this song, because it's perfection. Zero flaws. Perfect. So, let me know what you guys thought of this one in the comments down below, and subscribe for more Thin Lizzy Thursdays. Every Thursday, assuming my computer has not died, I will be doing a Thin Lizzy Thursday video. So, thank you guys so much for watching, and have a good one. Bye, everyone.